Hello friends, this is Kaushik and you are watching Learn to Code. In our last video, we got a glimpse of what a data is, what a keyword, what a constant, what a variable. So today we would start programming where we would learn how to implement these things in C program. So let's get started without any delay.
Click on start button, then click on bold and C++ shortcut icon. If you don't have this icon over here, then just write bold and then click on this icon. The editor opens, go to file, new, text edit. First we would be doing a very simple program to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, now what are the use of these two slash? These two are used for commenting any line in C program. That is, this line will be there in the editor but won't get compiled. It is only used for explanation or demonstration purpose. So it's known as commenting. So these two lines are used for commenting in a statement. Now let's begin our program. stdio.h void main. Now I will explain each and every line, but before that just let me complete the program. Now I have declared C India variables. Now let me assign the values to these variables. I will perform the add operation. Now time to print. Yes. Now that's the end of our program. Let's set the program first. Add sub dot c. Don't forget to save the program with the dot c extension, and otherwise it will get saved with .cpp, which is meant for C++ programming. So we will save it .c, that is for C program extension. Now we have saved the program. Now let me just illustrate for the purpose of each line. Now hash include st, sorry, tabbing stdio.h. stdio.h is a header file which contains standard library functions for input-output operation. STDIO stands for standard input-output. And for using this header file, we need to include the header file using hash include keyword. Now, why are we using this STDIO.h header file? Because here you can see we have used the printf function over here. Now, the purpose of using printf is to display any character or string or integer or octal or any number on the output string. So here the printf function will display result equals to the appropriate result, right? Now the definition of this function has already been defined to the compiler, and it is this definition is present inside this header file. So this is the system defined function, right? It is already there. We are just calling this function. We are only using this function. Now for using this function, we need to include this header file because the definition of this function is present inside this header file. So this is a header file. What is void main? It is the function, and also it is the entry point to any C program. Now this open. Now these two braces, curly braces, indicate the start and end of any function. So here it means that void main starts here and ends here. Then here we have declared three integer variables, right? Declared interior variables. Fine. Then here we have done the assignment. That is, we have assigned the value 15 to variable num1 and we have assigned the value 5 to num2. Assignment operation. Same here also. Now here what we have done, here we have done addition operation first. Sorry, addition operation and addition operation done and assigned to a variable. Fine. So the addition between num1 and num2 has been done and the result has been assigned to the variable res. Now it's time to print the output on the screen. So I've already told you that we are using printf for displaying the message on the screen. So here we need to comment as display the output on the screen. Now we are mentioning this comment just because suppose you have written a program and any third person is just going through your program. Now, this is a very simple program. He or she would understand. But when it's a complex one, when it's a complex logic implemented, it's always a good practice to write this comment line so that anyone apart from you who reads your program is able to understand what you have written or what you have tried to do. Right? That's the sole purpose of commenting in your program. Now, let us save and let us compile the program. It's absolutely fine, no errors. Now, let us run the program. Now, as you can see, the output screen is just coming and then going away. It's only flashing. So, for resolving this issue, we need to include another header file called conio.h. Now, what is the purpose of including this header file? Because we will be using this function henceforth, that is getch. Now, what is the purpose of this function? This function waits for user input. That is, in layman word, you can say it simply holds the output screen until and unless the user enters any character or presses any key on the keyboard, it holds the output screen. And the definition of this getch function has been mentioned inside conio.h. So in order to use this function, getch function, you need to include conio.h. This is also a header file. Let me save the program, compile it, absolutely fine, then run the program. Now you can see the output screen. You can see the cursor is blinking. It is just waiting for the user input. As soon as I press any key on the keyboard, this output screen would close. So I press about any key. Let me press the space button and the output screen is gone. So I hope this program is clear to you. Now, as written here, we need to perform the add, subtract, multiply and divide operation between two numbers. So we have done the addition operation. Now we can easily do the subtraction operation like this. You can see the result. Then change it to division, compile, run. You can see the result. Change it to multiplication, compile, run. So we are getting the result as the desired. Fine. Now let's move on to our next program. Now I have already written down our next program, that is to print the number or character entered by the user. So suppose we are not taking user input over here, we are manually assigning the value 5 to this integer variable x. Now let us consider this is the value which user has entered. The value 5 user has entered. Now let us print the value. Now in the previous program also you saw that while I use the printf statement, I use this format specifier %d. Now what is %d? In our last video also I told you that for printing integer variables, we need to make use of the %d format specifier. For printing character variables, we need to use %c. For printing float variables, we need to use %f. So what is the significance of this %d? Now, as you can see, this x is an integer variable, and the same we are printing over here. So as I told you, for printing any integer variable, we need to use this format specifier %d. So if we are printing one variable, we need to use this %d once. Suppose we would be printing this x variable twice, then we will also use the %d variable twice. %d format specifier twice. Just keep in mind that the format specifier would be replaced by the variable which we want to print. So in this case, we want to print x. So the format specifier %d would get replaced by the value of x. If we want to print a float variable, %f would get replaced by the value of the float variable. If we want to print a character variable, then %c would get replaced by the value of the character variable. So let me just compile and run the program for you. Compile and then we run. You can see the output is x equals to 5. Now suppose I want to display this 5 two times. So I will be using this format specifier two times. Compile, then run. You can see the 5, this is not 55, this is 5 and then again 5, so display twice. Fine. Now suppose this is not an integer variable, let us consider this to be a float variable. Now for printing float variable, we need to use the format specifier %f. Let us compile and run. I told you in our last video also, a float variable displays decimal places up to 6 decimal places, right? So you can see the same over here also. And let us consider if you want to a character variable. I told you for assigning characters, we need to make use of single quotes, and this will be C. So let us compile and run. You can see the character 5. This is not a number. This here it is a character. 5 is the character over here. Now if we don't give this single quotes, you can see this special symbol over here. Now why is this symbol being displayed here? Because if we only assign the value 5 to the character variable x, it won't treat 5 as a character. It would consider 5 as an integer variable and do some typecasting. Now, right now I am not explaining type. What is typecasting? I will explain this later. But as of now, just keep in mind that for declaring or defining any character variable, we need to make use of this single quote in order for it to be treated as a character. Otherwise, it would be treated as a special character. Fine. That's all for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, share and subscribe the video. And meet you with our next lesson.